Greetings, New Zealand naturopath Eric Backer, author of Candida Crusher and formulator of the CanXida range of dietary supplements. Here's a question I get asked from time to time from different people. Can antibiotics in meat cause yeast infections? Well, that's a very good question. Some people say yes, some people say no. I think the jury's still out on it. I've read lots of different studies on this particular topic, but there's nothing really defined that says yes they can or no they can't. But what I can tell you this is, in my opinion, after treating up thousands of people for many years, the people I see who recover a lot faster from yeast infection are people who tend to avoid commercial grain-fed meats, like, you know, if it's not the meats like cow and animals like that, looking at organic chicken in particular. Chicken is one animal that's been given lots and lots of antibiotics. So that's one particular meat that you really want to eat organically or free range. When I was a young boy, chicken used to be very, very expensive, and now it's very, very cheap. And in fact, it's one of the primary forms of protein here in New Zealand, and I expect in the US and many other Western countries as well. The average person consumes close to 40 kilograms of chicken per year now in this country alone. So the rates have really increased, which means production's really increased. What I can tell you about chicken, what I have also found out about poultry, is that the food is generally kept in large silos and treated with an arsenic compound to stop mold formation in it. And also that the chicken food can be sprayed with antibiotics. And some manufacturers are quite unscrupulous. When the birds produce waste, the waste come out, they're actually sprayed with an antibiotic residual spray and then fed back to the birds again because it's a high protein waste. Now that might sound disgusting to you, but it actually does occur, that kind of practice. So, and there's whole different types of antibiotics are actually given to chickens in particular. So poultry meat's one you really got to watch out for. So I found a little article here actually from Princeton University. Ciprofloxacillin is the antibiotic used to treat Campylobacter bacteria, which causes food poisoning and can cause chronic problems like Guillain-Barré syndrome and even reactive arthritis. Campylobacter affects 2.4 million Americans and causes 100 deaths per year. In 1990, the incidence of cipro-related illness was negligible. In 1996, the FDA approved an antibiotic similar to cipro for use on poultry. By 2001, the cipro resistance level in human Campylobacter cases had reached 19%. Some fast food chains like McDonald's, Wendy's and Subway now refuse to serve poultry that has been fed ciprofloxacillin. So hopefully more restaurants will join in soon. So if you've got candida, you want to eat organic meat. In New Zealand, we're lucky because most of our meats really aren't given these kinds of chemicals. Chickens are, but we have got an abundance of good quality free-range eggs and free-range chicken and plenty of fish. So I don't believe that candida can be caused as such by antibiotics in the meat. But I think if you eat commercial poultry two or three times per day and you're weak, it could certainly make you a lot more susceptible to getting candida. And if you can't shake candida and you're eating a lot of commercial meat, drop the commercial meat and go for free-range certified organic meat. That way you're not taking in any hormones or pesticide residues or antibiotics or chemicals like that that are going to weaken your body. Because you want to have a strong body, a powerful immune system that overcomes candida. And if you're continually consuming food with an antibiotic in it in a low rate, it's not a good idea. You're going to wipe out very small levels continually of beneficial bacteria that'll further weaken your body. So it's not really a good idea to do that. Don't forget to read my articles at yeastinfection.org. I think I've written some articles actually on antibiotics and also on poultry. There's a big section in my book, Candida Crusher, actually about poultry and antibiotics. Don't forget to do my quiz, yeastinfection.org. Check out my canxida.com. Product range, please. You'll find I make quite a nice antifungal and an enzyme probiotic formula. And the CanXida Restore in particular would be a good product for people who eat occasional non-organic poultry. So that's not a bad product to take. That's going to help to build up beneficial levels. So I hope that sort of answers your question on can antibiotics in meat cause yeast infection. I don't think it can actually cause it unless you're eating lots and lots of it every day. But I believe it makes you much more susceptible to getting a yeast infection, because it weakens your immune system, it weakens your digestive response, and allows you to pick up not just candida, but all other kinds of bad bacteria as well. Plus, it will reduce your level of beneficial bacteria. Thanks for tuning in.